Hello friends, Kishan is here again and welcome you in this video tutorial. In this video tutorial, I'm going to show you how to call custom SQL functions in Hibernate 5. So first of all, I want to tell you, in previous video tutorial, we have learned how we can call a store procedure in Hibernate, right? And we made use of a stored procedure query to call a store procedure in Hibernate. But when you have a SQL functions, your own custom SQL functions, and if you want to call it from Hibernate, then a store procedure query does not support you in that. Sorry, that's the reason you need to take help of callable statement, which is basically belongs to the JDBC, to call a store procedure. Sorry, to call SQL functions in Hibernate. So project already I have created. So let me explain you each and every files in this project. So let's start with my project is Maven based. So we have a pom.xml. There I have defined my all dependency which is required to develop a Hibernate application. So here you can see we are using MySQL database server. So that's what we have added dependency for MySQL connector Java. Now second dependency I have added for the Hibernate, and that's using 5.2.12. That's the latest version of Hibernate. So basically these two dependency will add all the required dependencies which is needed for the Hibernate application, right? So you can see all the dependency is downloaded from the Maven central repository, and that is added in my local Maven directory. Now here we have a Hibernate cfg.xml file which contains all the Hibernate related properties, and finally we have a two entity class, person and phone. Those two entity class also will have to register here. Here we are using the MySQL database is called test, right? So how this file create from scratch, already I have covered in the separate video tutorial. So if you don't know how to create Hibernate cfg.xml file, can be rename it as something else like my Hibernate or cfg or something like that. These things already I have discussed in the separate video tutorial. So to watch those videos, you can check my YouTube video playlist. So you'll get those videos. Now we have a Hibernate util which is basically responsible to create the session factory. So here we have a utility class is called get session factory that returns the session factory, right? And this is a static method, so you can call by its class name. Now once client call this method, right, which basically returns session factory, and that's gets created in this static block, right? And we know that a static block is loaded when your class loaded in your memory, right? So when you call any method, when you call this method, then first of all a static block will be executed, right? And session factories gets created in this static block, and same is returned to the client. So it's pretty straightforward how to write this class from scratch. Of course I have covered in the separate video tutorial. Now we have a two entity class as I have shown you. So we have a person and phone. Person to phone, we have a many to one to many relationship, right? Here we are not using a third table or join table to manage relation between person and phone. So we have added a person ID on the many side, means phone side, and that's the reason you can see mapped by I have given the person, and this is the variable name which we have declared over here. And in phone table, person ID we have defined as a foreign key. So in that case, in one to many association, you don't require a third table or join table. So this relationship you can manage in the two table itself, right? And from phone to person, we have a many to one join, right? Many to one relationship. So here, if you go to the person, then there is a one variable which I have, in phone we have one variable which is I have mapped as a enumeration, right? So how we can map enumeration in Hibernate, that also I have covered in the separate video tutorial. So to map enumeration, you will have to use @enumerated, and enumeration type you can give a string. So when you save phone details, and at the time you can set a landline or mobile, right? So you have also, if you do not specify this enum type, then by default that will take ordinal, right? That will take ordinal means zero for this and one for mobile. That's the ordinal. That's index of like similar to array. Okay, now we have a save data client test. So here we have created a two person object. Person one contains the one phone. So phone detail also I'm setting in the person, and person detail I'm setting in the phone, because this is, as I have shown you, these two entities related with the bidirectional relationship. Now person 2 is having two phones, right? So these two phones I have set it to the person 2, and I am saving the person 1 and person 2. So along with the person 1 and person 2, corresponding phone numbers will also be persisted into the database, right? So that's all about, if you can see over here, cascade type I have given all. So there are various type of cascading type. So if you select all, then you are selecting persist as well. Cascading means what action you are taking on the parent, same action you want to cascade with the children. That's the cascading. And I mean, this cascading type already I have covered in the separate video tutorial, like persist, remove, etc. I have some of the like detach, refresh, these are the things I haven't covered. So if time permits, then in future video tutorial also I'll cover this cascade type as well. But merge persist, these things I have already and remove already I have discussed in the separate video tutorial. Now what I'll do, I'll run this program so that Hibernate will create a table for us, and that will insert two records into the person table and three records into the phone table. Right here I can show you my database is a test, nothing is inside the test right now. So what I'll do, I'm going to run this project. So table is created and data inserted. If I go here, refresh, then you can see there are two tables. So in person table, you'll get the two records, person related information, ID, address, created on, name, nickname, version, and phone. There are three phones, right? So phone first belongs to the person whose ID is 1, and phone 2 and 3 belongs to the person whose ID is 2, right? So that's data we have inserted. Now we required a MySQL custom function. So already I have written MySQL custom functions. So this I have to run in my local database. So here you can see earlier we had created a stored procedure in this directory. So now you can see functions. There is a separate directory. Right click over here and say create function. So you'll get template like this. So I'm going to paste this code over here, and here I'm using MySQL workbench. If you are using some other tool like Toad or MySQL Yoke, in similar fashion you can create the function. Now you will have to click on this apply button. Now apply, again click in this apply and finish. Now in that way we have created a MySQL functions. If you refresh, see, you can see the MySQL function. Now how to call this MySQL function from Hibernate, that's the thing we are going to discuss now. So call SQL function in Hibernate client test, I have written the code, right? So here we want, first of all, let's see person whose ID is 1, how many phones belongs to this person. So here, as I said, as the documentation says, a stored procedure query is not going to support you to call SQL functions. So that's the reason we are taking help of callable statement. So in Hibernate 5, so that's the way to basically call the store function. So here we made use of the Javaite lambda expressions. So if you look on session dot do work, and do work basically takes work as an argument, and here we have made use of the lambda expressions, right? And lambda expressions, inside the lambda expressions we have written, we made use of the callable statement, and we are calling the prepare call method, and here that's the way to specify your SQL functions. So SQL functions always return some value. Store procedure does not return some value, that performs some action but doesn't return some value. But your function, after evaluation of your function is going to return some value, and that's the reason a store procedure always has a return statement, right? So those return statement, we are putting a placeholder, means that is unknown, and that takes one input as well, right? If you look into the store SQL functions, so that takes integer as a person ID, and that returns the phone count. Explicitly we have given the return, right? That's the difference between a store procedure and function. Function does return some value, a store procedure doesn't, right? So here callable statement, you will have to first question mark represents the your output, right? So that register out parameter I have used, so register out parameter will have to register. Now second parameter represents your input. So input parameter directly you can say callable statement dot set int, and index is 2. For this index 1 and for this index 2, you are passing this person ID which is coming from the client, and you call the callable statement dot execute, and this will execute the your SQL function. And what phone count is a type of atomic reference, right? So atomic reference is a method is called set. You are calling the set method, and callable statement dot get, you are trying to get the phone count which you have saved on the index first, and you come out from this code, nested code, right, from lambda expressions, and inside the out of this lambda expression I'm checking phone count not equal to null, then saying phone count dot get, this will return the total phone count which we have stated over here, right? So let's run this class and see whether this is working or not. So person ID I'm specifying as 1. So for person whose ID is 1, there is only one phone, right? So that must return value as 1. So let's see. Say okay. Cool. Saying the phone count is 1. Now you can see some alter table phone, right? So when you specify HBM to DDL as a update, then in Hibernate 5 is basically that basically recreates the foreign key association. If you specify validate over here, or if you remove HBM to DDL value, and in that case you will have to create the table manually, then this query will not be fired, and that's the basically modification have done in the Hibernate 5. But if you are using Hibernate 4, then alter query will not be fired if you specify update over here, right? Now for person 1, there is only one phone, so let's change the person ID as 2. For person 2, there are 2 phones, so number of phone would be 2. So we are expecting to get 2, and here we got the 2, right? So if you go to the database for person 2, person ID 2, there is a 2 phone. So that's the way to execute the SQL functions in Hibernate. I hope you understood how to call a store function in Hibernate, SQL function in Hibernate. So that's all I wanted to cover in this video tutorial. So I hope you enjoyed learning this video. If you did not subscribe my YouTube channel, then please subscribe it as soon as possible. And this code I'm going to check in on GitHub, and GitHub location you'll get in the video description. So thanks for watching this video, and see you next video tutorial.